Yes, that is my fish tank.
It looks much better without all the bacteria.
What? Edna just had it cleaned.
Yeah, but in 1931 it was full of bacteria that we used to make rocket fuel. Remember?
Stop trying to confuse me! My whole life has been dedicated to the practical use of technology to shape a more efficient, orderly society. Ask anyone. It's a fact. You can look it up.
But you know better, right? Emmett?
Wrong. Do you see this picture? I keep it close by me to remind me of the moment when my life's course became clear. August 25th, 1931. The day I single-handedly captured Kit Tannen, the scourge of Hill Valley.
Single-handedly?
And not incidentally the day I caught the eye of Edna Strickland, my scientific muse and the love of my life. Take a look. What you see there is a young man who understands his destiny.
That's not what I see.
What do you see?
Be? I think it is.
What?
It's me, and you, the other you.
It is me, and you. But how? Sonny? It's impossible.
No, it's science. Your science, Doc.
In this other world, the one you say you come from, Am I happy there?
Very happy. You've got two great sons.
Sons?
Yes, and a fantastic wife.
Not Edna?
Not even remotely. And your invention. Jeez, Doc, you can go anywhere you want to. Anywhere in time. You're the luckiest guy in the universe.
And what about Hill Valley?
Hill Valley? You know it's got problems. A little bit of urban decay here, a little bit of crime there. It's a normal city. People are happy, mostly. And even when they're not miserable like they are in your Hill Valley.
Stop! There are no miserable people in my Hill Valley.
Give me a break. You don't really believe.
My citizens lead lives of order and peace. Nobody worries. Nobody complains.
Only because they're afraid to. Jeez, open your eyes, will you? You and Edna have got them all terrorized.
That's Mrs. Brown to you, Sonny.
Doc.
Kindly address me as your honor. We've worked for over 50 years, my wife and I. Every waking moment devoted to ridding Hill Valley of vice and disorder. And you dare to claim that our citizens are unhappy?
Yeah, I do. I've seen it. They're just too afraid to speak up.
Afraid? Afraid of what?
Afraid of the consequences of their actions, Doc. You run this place like it's a police state.
Nonsense.
I can prove it.
All right then, time travel boy, you do that. And until you do, I'm gonna treat your wild story as just that, a story told by a madman. And I've determined that the best treatment is simply to let the insanity run its course.
So, is the interview over? Should I leave?
Please do. I'm very busy. I've got a city to run.
Fine, then I'll be back with proof. Aquan's proof that Hill Valley isn't the perfect place he thinks it is. One smoking gun coming up. Death!
Pop out the tape, son. I think it's done rewinding.
Whoa, take it easy. Sit here.
Guess I blacked out for a minute there. Fell out of my chair.
Fell nothing. Somebody whacked you.
Whacked me? Impossible. We take great pride in the fact that incidences of physical violence in Hill Valley have fallen to virtually...
Who did it? Can you tell me?
This can't be happening.
There's gotta be a clue around here somewhere. Dad, that's not one of our bats, is it?
No. McFlys never use aluminum bats. Curious.
Oh wait, don't touch it. It's evidence.
Of what? Oh, why would anyone do a thing like that to a nice Sector L citizen like me?
What's the last thing you remember?
I was sitting right here, copying another incriminating scene onto my tapes. My tapes! What happened to my tapes?
Stay calm, Dad.
Are they on the floor? Do you see them? They're in a box marked raw footage.
Here it is. Raw footage.
Thank heavens.
Wait a minute.
You see, I told you were just jumping to conclusions. All these dark suspicions about thieves and attackers went all the time. It was just...
empty.
What?
There's no tapes.
But I'm sure they were in there before.
Before whoever it was whacked you in the head and took them.
Oh my gosh, I've been mugged. Mugged in Hill Valley. They can't get away with it. Oh!
Don't worry, Dad. We'll get to the bottom of this.
Who could have done this to me?
Who stands to lose if those tapes get out?
Everybody who's badmouthed Citizen Brown and they didn't know a camera was on them. But that's half the people in town.
No, I'm guessing this was a lone agent.
Oh, it's no use. The tapes are gone. All I can do is hope against hope they don't surface and land me in trouble.
Come on, Dad. We can't just give up. I mean, maybe there's some more clues around here.
What's the use? Even if we find out who took the tapes, we're not going to be able to get them back without attracting attention to ourselves.
There's got to be something we could do to get our hands on those tapes.
Well, we can make new ones.
We can?
Sure. It may take a while, but if you're willing to help your old man out, it shouldn't take us more than, say, 6 months.
6 months? But I need those tapes now.
You need the tapes.
What I mean is... you know, your time is valuable. I would hate for you to have to redo all that work.
You said you needed the tapes.
And what if this mugger comes back? Another bang on the head might do you in.
You said you needed the tapes.
I gotta give it to Citizen Brown. I told him I was gonna furnish him with proof that Hill Valley isn't as happy as he thinks it is when I was in his office, just before I came here.
You had an interview with Citizen Brown?
It wasn't easy to get, believe me. I had to break all kinds of rules.
You've been breaking rules?
Harboring stray dogs, kissing girls in public, getting caught with Mom's flask.
That is the most far-fetched story I've ever heard.
It's true.
You forget I'm your father. I know your history.
Yeah, well, history's changed.
Prove it.
Read him and weep.
Demerits, but...
it was the only way.
I don't understand.
Dad, listen to me. I mean, really listen. You and I both know that things aren't right here. Citizen Brown might have started with good intentions, but his Hill Valley's just made everybody miserable.
Shh! You said that to him?
Basically, yeah.
Oh, there go our privileges.
No, wait, I got him to listen, Dad, and he's gonna make things right for you and Mom and all of us. I can't explain how. You're just gonna have to trust me on this.
Okay.
But first I have to show him your tapes, to prove my point.
Oh no, 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 no.
Dad.
This scheme of yours, maybe you know what you're doing, I can't say. But leave me out of
Dad.
It. I don't like trouble. I can't handle it. It's not in my genes.
But... think of your family.
I am. And I don't want to see my family relocated to Sector X with all the other hopeless cases.
It's your civic duty. Doesn't Citizen Brown always tell us
to keep our noses clean? And that's what I plan to do.
Do it for your father.
My father?
Yeah, Arthur McFly.
I know his name.
Didn't he have something to do with putting away Kid Tannen, you know, way back when?
Yes. Yes, he did. Where do you hear about that? It was way back, before Citizen Brown cleaned up the town, before I was even born. Everyone lived in terror of Kid Tannen and his goons. But Dad stood up to him. He had evidence of Kid's guilt, see, and he risked his life to deliver it to the authorities. Never be afraid to do the right thing. That's what he always used to tell me.
And what are you doing?
Trying to remember which is the right feed.
Feed to what?
to the surveillance camera, the one in the yard.
Wait a minute. You have a surveillance camera trained on yourself?
Of course. Gotta cover all bases. Now help me figure out which monitor I'm on. There, that looks like us. So the surveillance tape must be on this VCR. This must be before the attack. Let's see. I remember cleaning the playback heads at 5:30. The attack couldn't have been very long after.
Oh, it's Biff!
But it can't be him. The Citizens Plus program has rendered him as gentle as a... kitten.
Huh?
I can't understand it. It's not the way he's supposed to behave. Why, even the old Biff would
hey,
never...
Wait, what's that weird flashing on his wrist?
Let's find out. I knew this zoom and enhance feature would come in handy someday. Cost me a bundle at the hobby shop.
It's his digital watch. I wonder why it's doing that. Hey, wait, stop the picture. Can you zoom in anymore?
X11, you know what that means?
Not yet.
Lorraine!
Don't lay into me, George. I've got something very important to say, and then I'm going to be leaving again.
I've got something important to say, too. I was attacked
it's
and robbed...
It's always about you, isn't it? You can't just wait and listen to my news. Oh, no! You have to go and beat me to the punch.
Pull yourself together.
That's right. You two sort things out. I've got some business to attend to.
I'm more together than I've been in months, George. For your information, I haven't had a drink all day.
Biff!
Whoa, settle down there, fella!
You beat up my dad.
Do we have a problem here, citizens?
No, officer. Just a little misunderstanding. I'm sure we could work it out. Right, Martin?
Sure.
Okay. Let me know if you need any help, Mr. Tannen.
Now let's see if we can get to the bottom of this.
Yeah, let's. Why'd you hurt my dad, Biff? He never did anything to you in this timeline.
Timeline? What are you talking about?
Don't play dumb. I saw you on camera.
I can't hurt anybody. Thanks to Citizen Plus, I blow chunks whenever I even think about doing bad stuff. See?
If you didn't beat up my dad, then where have you been for the last couple of hours?
Well, I was...
What?
That's strange. I don't remember.
What's the last thing you remember before your memory loss?
Well, I was handing out flyers for the Citizen Plus program, just like I'd been doing all day. I just finished giving some leftover bologna to a cute little squirrel when Miss Edna came by.
Edna?
Yeah, she wanted to run a diagnostic on my Citizen Plus watch. I must have fallen asleep or something, because when she was done, it was an hour later. And then your mom came by.
So the last thing you remember before my dad got beat up is Edna fiddling with your watch?
Yeah, that does sound pretty bad, doesn't it?
Biff, your watch. Does X11 mean anything to you?
X11? Is that a new band or something? I don't go in for that new hippity-hoppity stuff.
It's not a band, Biff. It's a mode on your Citizen Plus watch.
Weird. I've never seen it look like that. Heck, I can barely get this thing to stop blinking. See? Cool!
Biff? Okay, that's weird. What's wrong with you? Did you attack my dad? Now we're getting somewhere. Why'd you attack my dad? You must have been hypnotized. Who put you up to this? Guess that'll have to wait until after I get the tape. Could you, touch your toes? Do the chicken dance. Yeah, he's hypnotized, all right. Where's my dad's tape? Recycling bin? Could you do me a favor and go get my dad's tape?
Hey, Mr. Tannen. What's up? Is that McFly kid bothering you? Hey, you can't go in there! Hey!
Whoa! Holy smokes! What happened to him?
I don't know. No one's ever jumped into the decycling bin before.
Well, where does it go?
That information is above my pay grade. Oh, jeez. I'm in a lot of trouble now. Don't move a muscle, McFly. I gotta go tell Citizen Brown about this.
Attention, citizen.
I've got a really bad feeling about this. Well, here goes nothing.
Gosh, ma'am, did I do something wrong?
Did I do something? Mr. Tannen, I put a lot of work into honing you as the first Citizen Plus. What on earth possessed you to assault a police officer and dive headfirst into the recycling bin?
Did I do all that?
Lord, I thought your father was dim.
No, really. I don't remember doing anything like that. The last thing I remember, I was showing that nice McFly kid my watch. Then, blam, I'm down here and you're yelling at me.
McFly? McFly.
Strickland.
Oh, hi, Martin.
Give me the tapes, Edna.
Mr. Tannen, please restrain our guest.
Stop! Stop! Oh no. Novelties? Biff, whoopee cushions. You never had much of a sense of humor. Hey, it's Wild Gunman. Not a fan of video games, huh? Hey, look over there. It's beer.
Beer? Huh?
Tannen, focus.
Oof.
Look at all these unhappy faces on your father's videotape. Well, Citizen Plus will turn those frowns upside down in no time.
Biff, isn't that the license plate to your car?
Sheila? What's going on?
Biff, Howard Tannen, obey your programming! You see, Mr. McFly, thanks to the enhancements I've made to the Citizen Plus program, I can bring even the most rabid of dogs to heel. So much vice and disorder. And to think, Emmett actually wanted to shut down the X-11 initiative.
Look! Girly mags!
Boobies! Where am I?
Tannen! I didn't go behind my namby-pamby husband's back so you could wallow in your vices.
Ow. Biff, aren't those your favorite cigars?
Cubans!
Tannen, listen to me!
Babes.
news.
What the fuck? Mommy?
Tannen, get up, you useless slacker!
Come on, Edna, give the poor jerk a break.
A break? You sound like my wishy-washy husband, always trying to find the good in people, never wanting to accept the fact that some people are just born bad.
Maybe, but that doesn't give you the right to turn them into zombies. Now, give me my dad's tapes so I can—
You mean those tapes I erased while you were struggling with my zombie?
What? Come on.
Utopias are fragile things, Mr. McFly. Especially when overseen by minds as distractible as my husband's.
No. No!
Edna!
Doc?
Emmett, what are you doing here?
I came down here to investigate a troubling report involving Mr. Tanner.
Doc, you gotta stop her. She—
Silence!
Okay.
I was concerned there might be a flaw in my Citizen Plus program. Imagine my surprise when I found my wife perverting my life's work. Is this what it's all been about, Edna? All those years? All our struggles to cure society's illnesses? Just to create a world where free will can be turned off with a flick of a switch?
Oh, please, Emmett. You wanted this just as much as I did. Remember? If only we could tell someone to stay off the grass, and so help us, they would never tread foot on a well-manicured lawn again. That's what Citizen Plus does. It makes rules unbreakable. I only gave it the slightest of changes.
Enough! We will not have this discussion here.
But—
Go home and wait for me.
Fine.
Doc.
Ah! Father, what have I done?
Doc, don't be so hard on yourself. This Hill Valley may be a little messed up. Okay, a lot messed up, but you were just trying to help people.
Or was I just entranced by the challenge of transforming the human psyche like so many chemicals?
I'm sure he wouldn't blame you for all this, Doc.
He was so happy when I gave up my childish dreams in favor of Edna's more practical pursuits. Are you proud of me now, Father?
I'm sorry about Edna, Doc. She didn't seem so bad back in 1931.
No, she wasn't. When we were first dating, she was so spirited, principled, compassionate. When did I lose her? Ah, enough wallowing. What's done is done. It's time to look forward.
Maybe, but maybe not.
What?
Your notebook from the other timeline.
Not this foolishness again.
Look, you can use it to repair the time machine and fix all this so it never happened. Everyone could be back the way they're supposed to be. You, Edna, Jennifer, my parents. Doc, you once told me if you put your mind to it, you could accomplish anything. Well, accomplish this.
There's a lot of empty pages.
The only one you need is right here.
This could work! It'll take time, of course, but once it's done, we'll have all the time in the world! Ha ha!
Doc?
Martin, we must get started at once. Come on!
We bring Einie along.
The dog, yes, of course. You know, I used to love dogs before Edna came along.
You don't say.
I'll go ahead and start preparing a lab. Edna will be furious, but who cares? We've got a time machine to fix. Woohoo!
Don't worry, boy. I'll get you out of here in no time. What is it, Einie?
McFly!
Hey, Biff. You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Better than I've been in a long time, you know?
So you remember...
that witch making me do stuff? Yeah, she'll get what's coming to her. No one tells Biff Tannen what to do. No one.
Hey, I'm the guy who snapped you out of it.
Really? Because all I remember is a punk kid who thought it'd be funny to make me jump down a hole.
Down, Biff. Stay. All right.
McFly.
Oh, crap.
All right, McFly, time to race the music.
Bass, it's face the music, you idiot. I hope I don't run out of rock. Einie, sick him. Place your bets. Let's get out of here, Einie. Doc! Sorry I took so long. Biff came around and jumped me. I totally laid him out with the old...
Martin McFly.
Edna?
It's almost impressive how many years of work and planning you nearly ruined in just a few short hours.
Where's Doc?
Doc. My husband is in a better place.
Better place? What have you done to him?
Relax, Martin. We've got everything under control.
Doc! No! Doc! Here's the real story. I'm a Marty McFly from an alternate timeline.
Edna, why?
Because you're weak, Emmett.
What can I say? She's my muse.
I'm not sure I like where this is going.
It's almost embarrassing how devoted he is to me.
You gotta believe me, Jennifer. This whole town's gone crazy, and Citizen Brown and I are the only ones who can fix it.
There is no future for us.